بسم الله، الحمد لله، الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. In today's lesson, inshallah, we will learn about another characteristic, استطالة. استطالة is a permanent attribute for only one letter of Arabic alphabet, which is letter ضاد. And it is more obvious and clear when the letter dhad is saken. The literal meaning of istitala is extension or lengthening. But in tajweed rules, istitala is the extension of the makhraj of letter dhad when we are going to pronounce it. In the makhraj of letter dhad, the deepest part of the sides of the tongue are touching the opposing molar, but your tip of the tongue is away from the gum line. But when you put pressure on the sides of the tongue, because dhad is an ista'ala letter, your back of the tongue is elevated. So you put pressure on the sides of the tongue, and because this is also an ittibaq letter, so the sound is compressing. When there is too much pressure on the sides of the tongue, your tip of the tongue automatically slides towards the gum line of the top two incisors. You put pressure over here, rest of the thing is going to happen automatically. You don't have to put your tip of the tongue close to the gum line of the top two incisors. You will start your makhraj from here by putting the pressure on the sides of the tongue. So the tip of the tongue will automatically slide towards the gum line of the top two incisors. Because if you will start your makhraj from the tip of the tongue, touching the gum line, and you keep your back of the tongue elevated, this will give heavy dal but not dhad. So you will put pressure over here on the sides of the tongue and the front will automatically move forward due to the compression from the back until the tip of the tongue touches the gum line of the top two teeth. And it will touch it lightly, not with too much pressure. So if we start our makhraj from the tip of the tongue and we keep our back of the tongue elevated, this will give us heavy dal. But we are talking about letter dhad, so start your makhraj from the sides of the tongue and not from the tip of the tongue. Because dhad is also a letter of rakhawa. Rakhawa means we have to give some time to the letter. This will also help us to give the characteristic of istitala when we give proper timing of rakhawa. But we need to keep in mind the timing of rakhawa for letter dhad should be same for rest of the rakhawa letters. We can take some examples. Yadrib. So dhad is a rakhawa letter. Dhad is an ittibaq letter. Dhad is an isti'ala letter, also an istitala letter. So I have to keep everything in my mind. So I should not be saying yadurib, yadurib. Now I'm not giving rakhawa, rather I'm giving shidda. So I have to keep this in mind and give time to letter dhad and istitala and keep my back of the tongue elevated and the compression of the sound is happening due to ittibaq. So I will say yadrib, yadrib, like this. So I have to keep all of these things in my mind while giving letter dhad. Another example could be wal ardi. If I'm choosing to stop, I will stop at letter dhad with a sukoon. So I have to make sure the timing that I'm going to give to dhad should be more than ra, because ra is a letter of bainiya and dhad is a letter of rakhawa. So I should be saying it like this. Wal ard, wal ard. The vibration that you are feeling inside your mouth, keep it inside and don't let it come out. Give it some time. If you leave the makhraj of letter dhad, this will bounce the letter. Instead of giving time, you are bouncing the letter. So instead of saying yadrib, so you say yadrib. The other thing that we need to keep in mind, if letter dhad is coming with a shadda, not a shidda, with a shadda. So in that case, you have to remember that the first dhad, when it is saken, you have to give timing of rakhawa. So you will not say waladdalin. You will say waladdalin. Give timing to the first saken dhad, timing of rakhawa, give istitala and rest of the characteristics as well. The next characteristic is al-ghunna. That is the nasalization. This is the nasal sound that comes from the nasal passage, our nose, when we are pronouncing two letters, letter meem and letter noon. This attribute of gunna is only for those letters, and no other letter should have this nasal sound. Gunna is coming from nose. It is a permanent attribute for letter noon and meem. But nose is not the makhraj of letter noon and meem. The makhraj of meem is coming from lips. The makhraj of noon is coming with the tip of the tongue touching whatever is opposite in the roof of the mouth. So that's the makhraj. But gunna is a permanent attribute for letter noon and meem. And you cannot give the proper makhraj unless you give gunna with these two letters. And this helps us to understand why letter noon and meem are the letters from bainiya or tawassut. If you talk about letter meem, so we are closing our two lips. That's the partial blocking. And sound is coming from the nose as well. So that's the partial running. If we talk about letter noon, the makhraj, which is tip of the tongue touching the roof of the mouth, is blocking from the front, and that is partial blocking. But sound is coming from the nose as well, so that's partial running. That's why these two letters are the letters of the wasat or bainiya. And you will see this characteristic of gunna when we will be learning about the rules of noon sakina and meem sakina. Some points that we need to remember during our recitation: do not add gunna with any other letter other than letter meem and noon. Very common example is jawf letters, which are all mad letters, alif mad, ya mad, and waw mad. When you are trying to give mad, do not add gunna. For example, if the word is ja'a, do not say ja'a. Now I'm adding gunna. If the word is qala, do not say qala, qala. Now I'm adding gunna. If the word is qila, do not say qila, qila. If you're adding gunna other than meem and noon, this is not right. Gunna is only part of noon and meem, and we don't need gunna with any other letter. When you are stopping with letter meem and noon, remember to stop with gunna, but do not stretch it too much to exaggerate it. For example, if I'm choosing to stop at the word ar-rahim, the word ar-rahim. So if I say letter meem without gunna, the sound will be like this. Ar-rahim, ar-rahim. This is not pure meem. This is more like a ba, or at least not a pure meem. So when I'm choosing to stop at meem, I have to close my lips. That's the makhraj. But I have to give the permanent characteristic of meem as well, which is gunna. I will stop like this. Ar-Rahim. Like this. And I have to remember that meem is a letter of bainiya or tawassul. So I have to give time of that letter. So I will say Ar-Rahim. But do not stretch meem too much to add more memes into it. Do not stop like this. Ar-Rahim. That's too much. When you're choosing to stop at a word and letter meem and noon have shadda on them, at that time you stretch the sound a little bit, but you do not exaggerate it when there is no shadda on letter meem. So in this example, if the letter meem having a shadda, I will stop like this, ar-rahim. But if the letter meem does not have shadda, I will stop like this, ar-rahim. So do not exaggerate the sound of the letter, because this will add extra letter meem or extra letter noon when you are choosing to stop. So the last characteristic that we will discuss in this topic is al-qalqala. The literal meaning is the bounce. It is the bouncing on certain letters when they come as a sakin letter, and those letters are only five: qutub, jad, qaf, ta, ba, jim, and dal. We only do qalqala on those letters when they come in a sakin condition. That's why scholars consider al-qalqala not a permanent characteristic, but a temporary and conditional characteristic. And inshallah, we will discuss about Qalqala in another video in detail, where we will discuss when do we do Qalqala, what are the different types of Qalqala. But for now, just remember that this is not a permanent characteristic, rather it is a conditional or a temporary one. So characteristics are divided into three groups: the strong characteristics, the weak characteristics, and the middle characteristics. And the strong characteristics are al-jahar, al-shidda, isti'ala, al-qubat, al-safir, al-qalqala, inhiraf, al-takrir, al-tafashi, istitala, al-ghunna. These are all strong characteristics. The letter that carries most of the strong characteristics is letter qa. The weak characteristics are al-hams, al-rukhawa, istifal, infitah, al-leen. And weak letters are those letters that have all the weak characteristics in it. And one of the example of the letter that carries most of the weak characteristics is ha, letter ha. The intermediary letters are the letters that have a mixture of strong and weak characteristics. An example of that is letter lam. Letter lam carries some of the strong characteristics and some of the weak characteristics. That's why this comes in the middle, in tawassut or in bainiya, because it carries some of the strong characteristics and some of the light characteristics. That's the end of our lesson of sifatul huruf. Insha'Allah, we will continue with the next topic in our next class. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.